Today, we'll start with exercise 5D. Okay? Exercise 5D. Few sums were left of exercise 5C, but I told you that we'll do them later. Let's start with 5D today. In the 5D exercise, we are going to study the formulas of sum and difference of cubes. Sum and difference of cubes. Up till now we were doing sum and difference of squares. Now we'll do cubes. There are two formulas in this exercise. See, these formulas are different from those formulas we did in expansion chapters. Okay, these formulas are different. The cube formulas in factorization chapter is different and in expansion is different. So don't get confused. Here, the formula for a cube plus b cube is a plus b, a square minus ab plus b square. This is the formula for a cube plus b cube. And if you have a cube minus b cube, then the formula is only the signs will get changed. This will become a minus b. Here, a square, this minus ab will become plus ab. This sign always remains the same. If the formula is for addition, plus, this first sign becomes plus and second becomes minus. If it is minus, the first sign becomes minus, second is plus. So accordingly, you have to remember the formulas. This exercise is similar to the exercise 5C which we did, and there are comparatively less sums in this exercise. Let's start. Exercise 5E is miscellaneous exercise and it will be omitted in school, so don't worry. We have to do till exercise 5D only. Let's start. Let's see the first sum. The question is a cube minus 27. Okay. First, we have to bring the question in this form. Okay. Where you have one cube and you have second cube. You must have two cubes. Okay. Here I have one cube, a cube. I'll write this as a first bracket cube minus this 27 is 3 cube. Okay. So I'll write this 27 as 3 cube. Now I have one bracket cube minus second bracket cube. That means I have a cube minus b cube. Okay. So I'll write the formula here. What is the formula for a cube minus b cube? It is a minus b, a square plus ab plus b square. Correct. Now in the place of a, I'll copy a. In the place of b, I'll copy 3. Okay. Just you have to just make two cubes on both sides. And if the sign is minus, use this formula. If the sign is plus, you have to use this formula. Okay. There is nothing new in this exercise. Only the applications of formula has changed. Okay. No new concept is there. So in the place of a, I'll keep it a. In the place of b, I'll write 3. So a square plus a into b means a into 3 plus b square means 3 square. This will become a minus 3, a square plus 3a plus 9. Okay. See, remember here the formula is ab. It is not 2ab. Most of the students make silly mistakes and they write their 2ab because you have a habit of writing 2ab. But here it is not 2ab, it is only ab. Okay. Next question. Question number 2. 1 minus 8a cube. Okay. 1 can be written as 1 cube minus 8a cube can be written as 2a. See, 8 is 2 cube and a the whole cube. Okay. So 1 cube minus 2a cube. Now this is my a minus b cube. Now it is in the form a cube minus b cube. So I can use this formula here. So I'll write the formula first. A minus b, a square plus ab plus b square. So here I substitute the value in the place of a. I'll write 1. In the place of b, I'll write 2a. So 1 minus 2a, a square means 1 square, plus 1a into b means 1 into 2a, plus b square means 2a square. Okay. So 1 minus 2a, 1 square is 1, plus 2a into 1 is 2a, plus 2a square is 4a square. Okay, this is my answer. Very simple, all the sums are similar. So the third sum, I won't solve it completely, but I'll just make brackets for you. You can solve that. 64 minus a cube b cube. This is the question for the third sum. 64 can be written as 4 cube, okay, minus a cube b cube can be written as ab the whole cube. Now this is your a, this is your b. Use this formula, subtraction formula, you'll get the answer. Okay, fourth one, I'll do it for you. Fourth one is a raised to 6 plus 27 b cube. Here also making brackets are important, otherwise you can solve it. See, this a raised to 6, I have a raised to 6, I want cube here, cube. So this a raised to 6 is nothing but a square the whole cube. Okay, see, this square, when you multiply, when you take cube of the square, so 2 into 3 becomes 6. So this is a square cube, because I wanted cube in the first bracket. Second bracket also I want cube. So 27 is 3 cube. Okay, and b cube is there, so I'll write b whole raised to 3. So this became 27 b cube, and here. So now I got two brackets, a cube plus b cube. This time I have plus, a cube plus b cube. So what is the formula for a cube plus b cube? The formula is a plus b, a square minus ab plus b square. This is the formula for a cube plus b cube. So in the place of a, I'll write a square. In the place of b, I'll write 3b. Substitute the values. In the place of a, let's write a square, plus in the place of b, 3b. Here a square means in the place of a, I'm going to write a square. And there is one more square here to understand. See, this entire thing is the value of a. So here it will come a square square. Because a, the value of a is a square. Minus ab means a square into 3b. Plus b square means this is the b. So 3b the whole square. Okay. So this will become a square plus 3b, a square square, so 2 into 2 will give me 4, so a4 minus 3b into a square is nothing but 3a square b. We write in sequence, first number, then a, then b, okay, plus 3b square, 3 square is 9, b raised to 2 is b square. This is my final answer, okay. Copy it down, pause the video and copy it down. And question number 5. Okay, so here you see, first, always remember, whenever, if there is possible to take something common from both terms, you have to take common, and then we can apply the formulas. Okay, so here also I can see that there are certain things which I can take common, like 3 and 81. 81 also has 3 as a factor, so I'll take 3 common first. So 3 can be taken common. Now this is x raised to 7 and x raised to 4. Okay, means there are 7x here and there are 4x here. So I can take x raised to 4 common. Okay, see, whenever you have single variable with two powers, the smaller power will come common. You can remember it like that. सो आउट ऑफ दिस 7x एंड 4x, 4x में कम कॉमन, सो एक्स रेज टू 4 विल कम कॉमन. हियर आई हैव 1y हियर एंड 4y हियर, सो आई कैन टेक 1y कॉमन फ्रॉम बोथ, सो y कम कॉमन. नाउ आई विल मेक ब्रैकेट. ओके सो वॉट एवर कॉमन आई टुक असाइड, नाउ दिस 3 इज गॉन. आउट ऑफ दिस x रेज टू 7, x रेज टू 4 इज टेकन कॉमन, सो वॉट इज रिमेनिंग, x रेज टू 3 इज रिमेनिंग. ओके y इज ऑल्सो गॉन कॉमन, सो नाउ नथिंग रिमेनिंग, सो दिस माइनस साइन. फ्रॉम हियर, फ्रॉम दिस 81, 3 इज गॉन, सो इफ यू डिवाइड 81 बाई 3 यू विल गेट 27 इज रिमेनिंग. ओके देन दिस x रेज टू 4 इज कंप्लीटली टेकन कॉमन, सो x रेज टू 4 इज गॉन. आउट ऑफ दिस y रेज टू 4 1y is taken common. So what is remaining here out of y raised to 4? Y cube will remain. Okay. Now I can write them as a formula. X raised to 4y. This can be written as this. X cube minus 27. Y cube can be written as 27 is 3 cube. So 3y the whole cube. Now this is a cube minus b cube. So I can apply the formula. A cube minus b cube. The formula is a minus b a square plus a b plus b square. So I'll keep this 3 x square y as it is. Okay, and here I'll substitute the values. So in the place of a I'll write x minus, in the place of b I'll write 3y. Here in the place of a I'll write x, so it will become x square. In the place of a again x, in the place of b I'll write 3y plus b square means 3y square, 3y the whole square, bracket close. Okay, so there is a bit space crunch here. Second bracket I am writing it here. So x square plus x into 3y is 3xy plus 3y the whole square. 3y the whole square means 3 square is 9. And then y square. This is my final answer. Okay. This is my final answer. Understood? Okay. Here I have a cube minus 27 a cube. So again this a cube is nothing but a the whole cube minus 27 upon a cube can be written as 3 upon a. See, 27 is 3 cube upon a the whole cube. Now this is a and this is b term. So I have a cube minus b cube. Okay, a cube minus b cube. The formula for a cube minus b cube is a minus b a square plus a b plus b square. See, writing the formula always is important so that you don't make mistake while substituting the values. Okay, so keep make a habit of writing the formula always. So in the place of a I'll write a, in the place of b I'll write 3 upon a. Here also in the place of a square plus a, in the place of b I'll write 3 upon a plus b square means 3 upon a square. So a minus 3 upon a square. See, here this a and this a will get cancelled. So what will remain? Only 3 will remain. Okay. Plus this 3 square is 9 upon a square. So this is my final answer. Okay. Next. Okay, so this is a cube, this is also some cube. Okay, but you won't be able to guess it directly. See, if you are able to guess directly, this is the cube of 0.4. okay, if you are able to do it directly, you can do. Okay, but if you are not able to guess directly which cube is this, so what should you do? this 0.064 can be written as 64 upon, see, the decimal point, after the decimal point there is 1, 2 and 3 numbers. So this can be written as 1, 2 and 3, 64 upon 1000. This number 64 upon how many zeros? After decimal there are 1, 2, 3 points, so 3 zeros. It can be written like this. Okay. Here, now you know 64 is the cube of 4, correct? 4 cube is 64, and 1000 is the cube of 10. It's very easy. 10 into 10 into 10 is 1000. Okay. So now I can write a cube plus 4 upon 10. The whole cube. Now it is easier for us to understand and grasp. So I got the answer. Here, in the next term, I can further simplify it. 4 upon 10. 4 upon 10 is nothing but 0.4. Okay, see, if there is 1 0, you put a decimal after one number. So one number is 4. So before that, we put a decimal. Here a 0 will come. So 4 upon 10 can be written as 0.4. Now I can easily make formula out of it, that it is a cube plus b cube. What is the formula for a cube plus b cube? A plus b, a square minus ab plus b square. Let's substitute the values in the place of a in the place of b, 0.4. a square minus a into 0.4 plus 0.4 square. Okay. So a plus 0.4, a square minus this a into 0.4 will give me 0.4a plus 0.4 square is nothing but 0.16. You can multiply and see 0.4 square, that is 0.4 into 0.4. If you multiply, you will get 0.16. Okay, this is your final answer for cube. Now question number 8, I want you to do on your own. Okay, first step I'll show you, next you can do it. This is the question. The first step is, if there is anything possible to be taken common, we'll do that. So here a is possible, I'll take a common, so I'll get a cube. See, a 4 may say 1 a is gone, so a cube remaining minus 343, and this can be further written as, this is a cube minus 343 is also a cube. Of which number you find on your own. Okay. Then you write that number here. 343 is the cube of which number, you write that number here. And then you apply the formula a cube minus b cube. And keep that a as it is. This a you keep it as it is in the answer also. A ninth sum. Okay, so here, see, I can apply the formula when I have first bracket with a cube minus second bracket with a cube. Here you see, even if there are two variables here, but I have an entire bracket with a cube sign. See, this is the full bracket with a cube sign minus. Here also I'll make a bracket with a cube sign. This 8x cube can be written as 2x the whole cube. Okay, so this is first bracket cube minus second bracket cube. So this entire thing x minus y is nothing but your a, and this entire thing 2x is b. So a cube minus b cube, formula is a minus b, a square plus ab plus b square. Okay, so a minus b means this is your a, x minus y. So in the place of a, I'll write x minus y. Minus b is 2x, so here I'll write 2x. See carefully, in the place of a I wrote x minus y minus sign, in the place of b I wrote 2x, again bracket. Now pay attention carefully, in the place of a I have to write x minus y, so this will become x minus y, and there is square also here, so x minus y square plus. In the place of a, again I'll write x minus y, okay, into b, a into b, b is 2x, so here it will come 2x plus b square. B square means 2x the whole square, bracket close. This sum is going to be a lengthy one. Here if you observe carefully, see carefully, x minus 2x, x minus 2x, x means 1x, so 1 minus 2, 1x minus 2x is nothing but minus x, okay, minus y. Then here I will have to use formula. See, I cannot open this bracket directly. This is x minus y the whole square, means this is a minus b the whole square. And what is the formula for a minus b the whole square? A square minus 2ab plus b square. Okay, so here also this bracket will get opened using the expansion formula, that is x square minus 2xy plus y square. Okay, plus I'll open this bracket. See, this 2x will get multiplied with x, and this 2x will get multiplied with minus y. So 2x into x is 2x square. 2x into y is minus 2xy. Okay. Plus 2x the whole square is 2 square is 4 and x square. Bracket close. Okay. The sum is not over yet, because there is some simplification left in the sum. Now see carefully, here this minus x minus y, I'll take minus sign common. I'll bring this minus sign outside. Okay, here now observe the like terms. I have x square here, I have plus 2x square here, and I have plus 4x square here. So 1x square plus 2x square plus 4x square, 1 plus 2 plus 4 is 7. So you will get 7x square. Okay, then minus 2x minus 2x, minus 2 minus 2 becomes minus 4xy. Minus 2xy minus 2xy becomes minus 4xy. And then what is left is plus y square. A single term is left, so I'll repeat here, plus y square. This is my answer. Okay, copy the sum neatly. Okay, pause the video and copy it. Tenth sum, you can do it on your own. I'll do the first step for you. The question is a cube upon 27 minus b cube upon 8. So this 8a cube upon 27 can be written as 8 is 2 cube. Okay, 2a upon this 27 is 3 cube. Okay, the whole cube, this can be written like this, minus this is b upon 8, again can be written as 2, the whole cube. So which formula will you use? There is a cube, this first bracket cube minus second bracket cube, that means this entire term is a and this entire term is b for you, and the formula which you will use is a cube minus b cube formula. Apply the formula here, substitute the values and solve. Okay, solve it slowly. You can even solve it now. Pause the video and try to solve it now and check your answer behind, whether you are getting it right or not. Okay. I have star marked this sum. Okay, because in this sum there are two ways in which students can start the sum. Okay, there are two ways in which you can start the sum, but we have to follow the first way always. How? See, this a raised to 6 and b raised to 6, a few students may write a raised to 6 as a square the whole cube. See, a square the whole cube, that means 2 into 3 is a raised to 6, is correct. Or you may write a cube the whole square. It can be done like this also. See, a cube the whole square. This is also 3 into 2 a raised to 6 only. So now there's a confusion whether to write it like this or to write it like this. Okay. Always remember, whenever you have power 6, okay, whenever you have power 6, we always write it in this way. First, we keep the square outside and cube inside. Always you have to write it in this way, where cube is inside and square is outside. Okay, so first we'll use this square ka formula and then cube. Always remember, whenever you have 6 in the power, first square will come out, cube will remain inside. Okay, square will be outside, cube will remain inside. Okay, so here also in this sum, I'll write a raised to 6 as a cube the whole square minus b raised to 6 as b cube the whole square. Okay, in a previous sum where you had a raised to 6, we wrote it as a cube, we wrote it as a square the whole cube. Okay, I did this because that in the second part of the sum, there was no a raised to 6. This method is used when both the powers are a raised to 6. Both the powers are 6. Only at that time, you have to remember that we'll take square outside and cube inside. Okay. Otherwise, we always use this method only. But whenever there are power 6 on both sides, first you take square outside. Okay. Now, if you observe this question, this is first bracket square minus second bracket square. So according to my formula, which formula? A square minus B square. We add both the brackets. We add both the terms and we subtract both the terms. Like if I have A square minus B square, it becomes A plus B, A minus B. Okay. So here, see, first bracket square minus second bracket square. So I'll add both the brackets, subtract both the brackets, because there is square sign outside. If there is square sign outside, I'll have to use the square formula first. So this will become a cube plus b cube, a cube minus b cube. Okay. Now I will use the formula a cube plus b cube here. What is the formula for a cube plus b cube? A plus b, a square minus ab plus b square, and then I'll use this formula here in continuation, a minus b, a square minus ab, sorry, plus ab plus b square. This formula I wrote here, and then this formula I wrote here. So my final answer is this. These four brackets are my final answer. Okay, copy this sum. You can even write alongside the sum, you can write also, take square first. So we use the square formula first. A square minus B square formula was used first. Then I used cube formula. Okay. Whenever both terms are raised to 6, you have to follow this method. Where first we will use cube, sorry, first we will use square, and then we'll use cube. Okay, now in this sum, here in this sum, I have a raised to 6, I have this is the question. Now here we have to split the middle term, okay, because this is an equation form. And we can use substitution method also to make the sum easier. Like what I'll do, see, we'll take let a cube is equals to x. Let a cube is equals to x. So if I take square of a cube, what will be the square of a cube? A raised to 6. Okay, so a cube square means nothing but x square. A cube is x, okay, so a cube square is nothing but x square, and x, where this is a raised to 6, that means value of a raised to 6 is x square. You can understand it like this also. I can write this a raised to 6 as a cube square minus 7a cube minus 8. I have taken a cube, let a cube is x, so in the place of a cube I'll write x square minus 7x minus 8. Okay, now the sum became normal sum like we did in exercise 5b, middle term splitting. See, x square minus 7x minus 8. Let's split the middle term. See, this must be the product and this has to be the sum. Okay, so how to split 8? 8 can be split as 8 into 1. 8 ones are 8. Okay, but I want minus 7. Okay, I want minus 7, so I'll put minus sign to the greater number and plus sign to the smaller number. So minus 8 into plus 1 will give me minus 8, and minus 8 plus 1, if I add them, I'll get minus 7. So this is the splitting. Let's split. This minus 7x can be written as minus 8x plus 1x minus 8. Now I'll take x common in these two terms, x minus 8 plus, here I'll take 1 common, x minus 8. So x minus 8, x minus 8 will come common. This will be x plus 1. Okay, but now resubstituting is left. We had taken x as a cube. So I'll write here, resubstitute x is equals to a cube. So in the place of x, I'll write a cube minus 8 and here a cube plus 1. The sum is not over yet. These brackets can be further expanded using cube formula. Okay, how? Remember, what was the first bracket? The first bracket was a cube minus 8. Here is the bracket, a cube minus 8. I'll solve this first here. A cube minus 8 can be written as a cube minus 2 cube. This 8 can be written as 2 cube. Okay. So which formula will be used? A cube minus b cube formula is a minus b, a square plus ab plus b square. This is the formula. Let's substitute in the place of a, in the place of b, let's substitute 2. So I expand this, I'll get a minus 2 a square plus a into b. A into b is a into 2, which will give me 2a, and then b square. B square means 2 square, which is 4. So I got this. When I solved a cube minus 8, I got this. Now I'll solve the second bracket. Second bracket was a cube plus 1. I'll solve it here. A cube plus 1. A cube plus 1 can be written as a cube plus 1 cube. 1 can always be written as 1 square, 1 cube, anything. Okay. Here I'll use addition formula. So what is addition formula? A plus 1, a plus b, a square minus ab. Ab is a into 1. 1a. See, a into b means a into 1 is a only. Plus b square. B square means 1 square. 1 square is again 1. So for this bracket, I got this answer. And for this bracket, I got this answer. So final answer for the question will be, we had to multiply these two brackets, means this first answer into the second answer. So final answer will be a minus 2 a square plus 2a plus 4 a plus 1 a square minus a plus 1. See, this bracket was written as this. This bracket was written as this, and this bracket was written as like that. So this is your final answer. It was a lengthy sum. Solve it properly, one below the other, each and every part. Okay, I hope you are able to see the sum. Copy it properly, each and every step. That's it for today. We'll solve these sums only. Now, 5 sums are remaining. We'll do the 5 sums in next class. I'll give you some homework. You have to write the formulas a few times and you have to do the solved examples also. I'll send everything in group. Okay? Thank you.